Back in the day when the Dollar Tree, which I believe was known as the $1 store, first came out, we were amazed at all the products we could get for a dollar. We can get snacks and cookies and toiletries and cleaning supplies all for just $1. Paper products all for just $1. They made a commercial poking fun at it, and the guy would pick up everything in the store and said, "How much is this? A dollar?" And he would pick up something else, and the customer service person would say, "A dollar," and he would pick it up again, "A dollar, $1," you know, because it was unbelievable that all this was for $1. Now, there's another store called the Dollar General. I used to get that mixed up. When they first came out, I said, "Oh no, this is the Dollar General." Well, the Dollar General is what it means. It's just what it says. It's generally a dollar, but not just a dollar. Now, when it comes to grace, and when it comes to salvation by faith through grace, and Jesus having paid it all, it's not generally so-and-so, a little this, a little that, maybe, iffy. It really is, he paid it all. You know, it's like the dollar store. Nope, boom, that's all it cost. And this case is Jesus' blood is what your sin debt cost. Nothing more, not your church services on Wednesday, not all the things that you involved with, not how much you tithe. That's it. The blood of Jesus. Is there anything else? Are you sure? Is this my salvation? That's all it cost, was the blood of Jesus. Because nothing else would pay that debt. And it wasn't generally speaking, iffy, you do this and this and then maybe no. Now, the difference is, you might not walk in the power, the authority, the anointing, and the full blessings and the confidence because of if your walk in Christ is not yielding to the lifestyle and allowing the Holy Spirit and the Word of God to help you grow, you know, to grow into the full measure of Christ. You might suffer some things because that comes with life, period. But you might not have the victories because you're not aware of, you don't get a clear vision of what Christ did at the cross, when he died on the cross, when he was crucified and died on the cross, when he was buried, we were buried with him. When he rose from the grave, we rose from the grave. And when he is seated in Christ, we're seated in Christ Jesus. And when we get the revelation and the understanding of Jesus paying it all and what those steps and those did for us, then we can fully walk in the privileges and the promises that we are afforded through the blood of Christ. But like what at the store, when you go to, that's just one price. For your sin debt, one price. Nothing else. Nothing you have to add to it. You do not have to win your salvation because it was paid for in full. There's no remaining debt. It's cleared. And what a beautiful thing when you go someplace and you know you have a debt, and all of a sudden someone decides, "Well, let's just take care of this. Let's just clear this." I had a library fine, and I get there and the lady, "Oh, that's so long ago. Did you return that?" I said, "Yeah, here's this book, da da da." And they cleared the debt. You know, because the books were returned, there were some fines. They cleared the fines. It's a good thing to know that in Christ, all of the penalty of our trespasses and sins have been cleared by the blood of Jesus. And don't insult Jesus' death, you know, his crucifixion, his death, his burial, his resurrection and his ascension by trying to add something on to what he came through the ages to do in the fullness of time to deliver me and you from our sins, past, present, and future. It is paid in full. There's nothing else. The debt has been cleared in Christ Jesus. So I pray you grow into that revelation so that you may experience the privilege and the promises and provisions that we have in Christ, as we sit in heavenly places in Christ Jesus far above principalities and powers in a new kingdom, the kingdom of God. May God bless you, and may this song encourage you. Anytime you hear this old hymn, may you think Jesus paid it all. And walk by faith and not by sight, and let the process of becoming more like Christ yield yourself to the Holy Spirit and allow him to do it. And don't let anybody else say, you got to walk this way, talk this way, do this and do this. Let the Holy Spirit lead you into the things that you need to yield to as you study his word, as you spend time with him in prayer. He'll lead you there. Jesus Christ, he paid it all. Just because he loves you so that he gave his only begotten son, to whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. John 3:16. He didn't come to the world to condemn you, to put you down. He came in this world that you might have life, and life more abundantly. An intimate life with Christ, where you can come boldly into the throne room of grace and receive mercy and help in time of need. A life authoritatively, for greater is Jesus that is in you than he that is in the world. And a life abundantly in Christ. God bless you. Jesus paid it all. You are so worth his free gift. Economic uncertainty, COVID-19, social unrest are all alarms that this world is in need of a savior. Perhaps you're having personal problems, marital challenges, financial or job issues, are indications, it's an alarm, that you are in need of a savior. In times like these, we need to realize we're part of the all club. And the whosoever club, the all club says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Come over to the whosoever club. All ye like sheep who have turned astray, turn to Jesus, who has turned to you and given you life eternally, abundantly, victoriously. All you have to do is say, Jesus Christ, forgive me of my sins. Come into my heart and be Lord of my life.